Shisha Pathak from Jinnah Sains has a structure like all others. And what is that structure? We have will or shall plus have plus being plus the present participle of whatever name verb that is used. The present participle of whatever name verb that is used. That constitutes the future perfect continuous tense. Now, what is the use of the future perfect continuous tense? What is its use? It has the same bearing with the future perfect tense, just like the other ones. That is talking about the present perfect tense and the present perfect continuous tense, or the past perfect tense and the past perfect continuous tense. There is some level of similarity in function between the future perfect continuous tense and the future perfect tense. Now, what therefore can we use it for? What therefore can we use the future perfect continuous tense for? It is used when an action is continuous in the future. It is used when an action is continuous in the future. And just like the future perfect tense, there's also time expression for the future perfect continuous tense. So let's take an example. By the end of this month, I shall have been studying in this town for 5 years. So you look at that, it therefore means that at some point in time in the future, I shall have been spending this time. Now, what that means therefore is the fact that by the end of the month, I will have completed 5 years, but obviously I won't be leaving the town. But it will tell us that I have completed that time. But the action of studying in the town will obviously still be in the future. But if we use the future perfect tense, it will give you a little bit different meaning. I shall have studied in this town for 5 years. It gives you a precise stop to complete the 5 years without the sense that the action of studying still continues. That is where the difference comes in.